look, I'm telling you, bit shit you'll hear about Jack is mostly fumit. Dragon shit, let's go back, I've had a few hits, and I'm feeling profound. Bits, I think it's high time that I told you a tale, plus when I'm high, I'm predisposed to regale, and since it's my dime, so to speak, I'll expound. This is a fairy tale, well, more like an extended metaphor. I have found that framework works better for explaining how it's not Jack's fault. So call me back in Charles Perrault. Long ago, far away, though in fact neither of those is true. But once upon a time still works, I guess it'll have to do. Well, anyway, there was a kingdom of ice. This patriarchal monocracy boasted a noble king. So wise, so wealthy, so famous, so handsome, so everything. As if they're one enough, I know him, he's nice. And his people thrilled when he fought and killed mighty dragons. It came to pass that the king and his queen were blessed with a prince. So what of a fat, ugly baby, but he's gotten better since. Yeah, we both know to whom the fuck I allude. As he grew up, it was more than apparent he had the gift. Just like his father, the young prince was noble and strong and swift. What else was anyone supposed to conclude? Like the king before, our prince slew a score of great dragons. This is a fairy tale, and what fairy tale have you ever known? With a bright, clear path leading to the throne, but first a prince must go through hell. Our prince would learn this all too well. The kingdom rejoiced each time the prince dispatched the foe, and the king could not contain his pride. But in secret the prince fought dragons only he could know, for these dragons' lairs lay deep inside. He would pore over legends of his father's deeds of yore, of the battles fought and prizes won. And his dragons would gnash their teeth and thrash about and roar that he'd never be a worthy son. Then one day the prince was gifted an enchanted medicine. When he took it, he was lifted as it fell the beast within. So he took the medicine more and more, and he vanquished many a beast of lore, such as griffin, trolls, and a manticore. But he had no clue what lay in store, for the medicine had unlocked the door, out of which a new dragon burst and tore through the prince's life and the prince's core, and he couldn't flee, fight, or ignore. Ah, he lost control and was swallowed whole by this dragon. He succumbed to his dark spell, and when he awakened, well... All through the Ice Kingdom, news of the prince's defeat had spread. Shocked and disgusted, they all turned their backs and left him for dead. But worst of all, the king was ashamed. Now that might be the end of my tale, were there some other prince. But this is our prince, and it shouldn't take too much to convince you. He won't rest until his birthright's reclaimed. Jack acts like he does, because once he was plagued by dragons, and he sometimes still is. This is a fairy tale, and it's one that we're both a part of now. A new chapter we're at the start of now. We have a say in how this goes. Jack's conquered foes, now he needs Rose to end his fate.